Hello everyone, welcome to Asan Services, and today I'll be taking you through the Asan Kitchen. That is one of the software that it is a cloud-based system that you can use in your modular kitchen business to handle all the different kind of things that is happening in your business, right from you create a quote. So it basically starts from quotation. If you are doing any other stuff, then I mean before creating quotation like designing and 3D designing and all that stuff, that is not covered here. So once you create the quote, or basically right from how you can easily create the quote, it starts from there and then it goes to other stuff. I'll be explaining in the video itself. So basically who all can use, and I'll just first summarize all the things that you can do in this. First of all, if you are a manager or an owner, it is a cloud-based system. You can use this system in your mobile, your iPad, your laptop, your desktop, wherever you want. So basically, you just need an internet connection and a browser, basically, right? So you can use it. And the second part is that you can create multiple users to it. So for example, in your business, you are having 3, 4 or maybe multiple employees working on the system. Then you can create multiple users to it. They can log into the system. And when they will log into the system, they can create codes, they can create purchase orders, they can create bills and whatever things that you're doing in generally in a modular kitchen business, right? So it's a kind of it handles the basically all the different activities in the kitchen business. And other than this, it's a kind of CRM also. So it takes care of lots of things, right? So it's a summary of that. I'll just explain you what exactly is happening inside. Let's start from the beginning. So as I told you, like, it's a cloud-based system, so you can log in anywhere, anytime. There's no restriction on the device or the location and anything. So let's say I'll just log into the system. Everybody will be logging. So this is the login screen from where everybody will be logging in, right? You, your employees, and anybody it could be. You just log into the system. Okay. So once you log into the system, you can see this is the dashboard. So I'll just take you through the dashboard first before going into further. So you know, how many numbers of client that you're receiving, coming to your business, right? So this is the total number of clients that you are having in your business, total number of quotes. So you may have a different number of clients and different number of quotes here. So how many quotes you are creating? How many purchase orders you are creating? So purchase order is basically the kind of purchase order that you send to your vendors from whom you purchase certain items when you are working on any site, right? And how many number of vendor you have? So it's a small graphics of what exactly is kind of stats that you have. Then we have total quotes per month. So as you can see, there are two things: month wise quote and the month wise quote convert. So basically you have two things. One is that you business comes to you, they ask for quote, but quote is actually not converting into sales. So you can see how many quotes you are receiving in a particular month and how many quotes are actually converting to a sale. So this way it will give you a insight. The second thing that you can see from here is the total payment per month. So this pink bar will give you information that how much total payment you are having, you are expecting to receive every month. And this color of bar will show you how much payment is pending, still pending. You have to receive, but somehow it's still pending, right? Then you have this site status progress. Okay, so you may have multiple sites working on simultaneously, so you know, on two sites I have Corcus installed, on two sites the material has been delivered, and these are certain other site progress that we have, like material delivered, carcass installed, hardware installation is done, shutter installation and handover, material in case of return, right, client feedback form. So that is the last thing that generally happens. Then you have different kind of clients. So it is just a bifurcation, or maybe the different type of people we have put in. Like you may have the client coming from advertisement, maybe architects, others, referrals, or maybe the walk-in. So you can know, I have 8 clients walk-in, right? 3 clients from architects that you have contact with. Now the another thing is the total complete quote and total pending quote. So how many quotes is completed and how many is basically pending? So month-wise total complete kitchen and month-wise total pending kitchen, basically. So it's not quote, actually kitchen I'm talking about. So you know, okay, I mean, how many kitchens you have completed this month and how many kitchens are still pending this month. So this is the kind of stats that you can have. I believe that this covers most of the things that generally a manager or owner look into any business. Okay, now I come to the thing. So let's say your employees comes into the system, right? So few things you need to configure before using this system. Let's say, first of all, you need to create the carcass. So carcass, or you may call it kit, and I mean, it all depends, like different people have different nomenclature for it. So you can basically create the carcass, right? The carcass by main app, for example, let's say I have utensil kit one, something like that, right? You need to tell how many shutter that kit is going to have. So these are the few masters that you need to decide before creating the code. So let's say number of shutter is 3, then you need to tell what is going to be the ratio of these shutters. So let's say 1.00, 1.00, 1.00. It means all of the 3 shutters height is going to be basically same, right? What is the rate of the carcass? You can put something like that. That all depends on your price. What is the shelf price that you have, right? Something like that. Number of shelves that is going to be there. Okay, direction of shutter. So direction of shutter, you need to decide, I mean, is it horizontal or vertical? And also you need to decide is if this carcass is going to be a top unit or a floor unit, where it is. So let's say top unit, right? I'll just save it. This way you need to add multiple kits, or you could call it carcass. As you can see here, I've done it, multiple things we can do. Second thing that you need to add is the components. So in components, you have basically 3 things. You can add a drawer, you can add a hardware, you can add a shutter type. So I'll just start with the drawer. So you need to start with the drawer. I'll just give a dummy name, drawer one. I'll just put some size here, right? Something like that. So any random size you can put. LN code if you have, you can put in here. Price of drawer you can put. Just put some random price. You can also decide the GST, whatever GST is applicable there. And also, okay, so base and back. This is something that if you include base and back and not. If you don't include it, it is not a kind of drawer which have base and back, then you can leave it. If it has base and back, you can put it. You just need to put the height of the back, because that is going to be different. Otherwise, all other things can be taken from the carcass itself. So you put a back height, right? I'm just putting random. And base and back price, if it is a different price than carcass and all that, you can put the base and back price as a whole. Okay, I'll just save it. So you can say drawer has been added. Now I'll just add the hardware part. I'll just put random name here just to recognize it properly. Hardware one, I'll put some size to it. Again, price per unit you can put it here. Let's say 500, LN code if it is there, GST if it is applicable, you can put it here, right? Is accessory, if it is an accessory or not, you can decide. But I mean, in this case, it's same, accessory and hardware is same here. So you just click on save, hardware is added. The next thing that we need to add is the shutter type. So shutter type could be anything, I mean, it depends. I'll just put it some dummy name here again. Price per square feet, let's say 50. Notes if you want to put something. Also, you need to decide if it's an extended shutter or not. So at some point of time you have extended shutter, right? I mean, it doesn't actually fit in there, so you can just decide over there. I'll just not put it here. I'll just save it, and this way you can have multiple shutters. So this way you need to add the multiple components that you have. Remember, see, these things that I'm doing, it is only one time you need to do. It is not like every time you have to do these things. Only one time you need to do it, and these are the masters that you have to create. Once it is done, then it's very easy. Third part, you can create skirting. So if you are using skirting, I mean, you can add skirting, right? I'll just another, again, I'll give some name, skirting, skirt 1, some width, height. I mean, it all depends. So I'm just putting some random price, and you can push the price as well. Once you have done all these things, right, these 3 things, basically you have created components, you have created skirting, you have created carcass, and all those things you have created, this is the masters that you have created, that's it, nothing else. Now, when your user will log in to the system, they will be looking at only quotes, clients, vendors, and purchase orders. They will not see all these things, and they cannot decide the price from here, basically. Okay. Now I'll start from customer perspective. Let's say customer comes into you, comes to your business. First of all, you need to go and create a client here. You just ask their name. I'll just put a test name. Their name is test. Let's say, okay, I'll just put some. Let's say Aman, their mobile number you need to put. I just put it some random number, 9898 9898 9898. Okay, alternative mobile number if they have, their email address in case they have some random address. Right, Punjabi Bagh, Delhi. I'm just putting some address, some notes. What kind of client is it? Is it an architect, others, referral, walk-in? What kind of client it is? Let's say it's a walk-in client. I'll just save it. Right. Okay. So I've created a client by the name Aman here. Now, second thing, I'll go to quotes. I'll start creating quotes. What I'll click, I need to click on add wooden quote. I need to select the client. I have selected Aman. I'll just need to go to skirting. I mean, what kind of skirting? So let's say I've select skirting, number of skirting, quantity you need to select. Let's say two. What kind of installation is it? I mean, is it a kind of square feet? Square feet price, or is it total price? Let's say I'll put total price. In case you put square feet price, then also you need to put a total price. Basically, it will divide that price with the square feet. So I'll just take total price in this case and installation price. I'm just put some random price here, 2000 discount. You want to give some discount to the users, you can say, okay, let's say I'll give the 10% discount to you, and please enter 2-digit M verification code, right? This code is basically from the the margin perspective. So by M verification code, by MV means the margin. So this, you need not to put any margin over here. A margin is already defined in the settings, but if you want to change the margin, you can change the margin on whatever the margin you put here. That will be automatically included in the total cost of the quote, basically. Okay, I'll just not put anything here. So let's say I'll put 25%. Just that's a number. 25% is there. Now you need to select three colors. Most of the times, the kitchen that you create, generally it has three colors. You can put the code, or you can put the name, it, color itself, that you can decide yourself. Let's say I'll put red, green, yellow. I'm not good at designing, so I'm just putting some random color here. Okay. So now you need to decide. Like, okay, let's say first create the top unit. So you click on top unit, right? Or maybe you want to first create a floor unit. You have floor unit, and you select the kit name. Any kit name you can select. Let's say cooking kit. Okay. Now number of duplicate kit, right? Number of duplicate kit. What means? Let's say you are going to create a kit. So what we mean by a kit is, on the floors you have certain kits. I mean certain piece, modular pieces. Basically, you can see, and then the same way you have on the top. So for example, you are creating two kits which are exactly similar to each other, then you need not to create it every time. You just click on number of duplicate kits, let's say two. So it will create two kits random. You can select the width of it, the height of it. What kind of shutter is it? You may have a kit which doesn't have any shutters. You can say shutter not applicable. Otherwise, you can just select any kind of shutter here. So shutter color, so let's say actually it already knows that in cooking kit there could be three shutters. So you need to shutter one will be, let's say, color A. Now why we have put color A, color B, color C is that at any point of time, at later point of time, the client may ask you to change the color, right? At that point of time, you don't need not to do anything. You just need to basically go on the top here itself, red, green, yellow. You just change the color here and everything will be taken care automatically. Now you just need to add, I'll just put, let's say, sorry, shutter 2, I'll just pick up, maybe the same color. I'll just pick third one and then I'll say color C, add, okay. Now you come on to the end side panel, so you need to select how many. So here it says two quantity, first one, what will be the color, let's say 1, right? I mean quantity 1, whatever the quantity, 1 or 2, you can decide, right? And what is the color of that? Now drawer type, you can decide, drawer one is going to be what kind of, like drawer 600, then you have draw 2, you can again decide whatever is it. I mean, it all depends on you. You are the master of your business, so you know better on that. So this way you can do it. And then the hardware that you are putting in, any, it could be the SS3 or anything, the hardware that you have in, like guest laptop. What is the quantity of that you need to put here? Add any other hardware that you are putting in, let's say DPO basket, whatever. Add. Now you have basically added all these things, right? And you just need to click on view price and you can see the price here. It will automatically take the price. Once this kit is done, you just need to click on add kit. Once all these things done, total price will keep coming here. Kit has been added over here. Now you can add another kit. Let's say floor kit, right? And again, you can just create another kit the same way that I've created this way. This time, let's say utensil kit that you're creating. You can again decide the weight, height, and side door. Right. Shutter 1, color A, shutter 2, color B. And side panel again, you can decide, let's say 2, color is B. Door 1, this one, sorry, you need to add. Door 2, the box, you need to add. Again, hardware, you can decide, let's say handle, 5. Okay, I'll just not add anything. You can view price. So this price is basically for this kit, and once you add this kit, this total price will change. So this way you can add multiple kits to it. I mean, the kits on the top floor, kits on the floor unit, kit on the top unit. And once everything is done, I mean, you have created all the kits, you just need to click on save code. Once you say save code, that's it. Everything is done, your code is created. And as you can see, you have created a code for client Aman and all these things are done. Now I'll just show you a few things. You just click on here and every details will be here. So this is the details of the client for whom you have created, right? And here is the details of, like, you have basically put two kits, your cooking kit, utensil kit, what is the width, height, depth, how many quantity you have. Top kit data we have not added this time, but if, when you will have it added, you can see here. Extra details you have not added. Payment details you can see. So you can see, okay, this 54,615 is the subtotal. This much discount you have given, this is the installation charge, and this is the pending amount. So pending amount is basically this amount minus this amount plus installation charges and all this. So this is the details for you, it is not for the client. You can just close it. Now when client will ask you, you just need to click on GST, and here you can basically see the quotes, right? Just click over here. So this way you can create a quote, and this quote format can be changed, I mean, as per your requirement. This, so you can see like what all kit we have added, their quantity, their price, and the subtotal is there. Then we have the discount price, installation charges, CGST, SGST, total kitchen price, and few terms and conditions, these all this. So this is the format that you can change. It is not a mandatory thing. I mean, it is not a hard code thing here. I'll just close it this time. Okay. Now I'll just explain you a few more things. So since you have created a quote, now what you can do, going to U, you can update the quote. Going to P, now P is basically the payment part. Once you click on P, you need to tell, okay, 51,000, this much was the expected receivable. How much advance you are receiving? Let's say you have received 20,000. What is the first installment, second installment that you can decide? You just click on update. So it will be done. Now this way, now if you go here, right, it is showing you the pending payment as 31,153 because 20,000 has been paid as an advance. So this way you can see all the payment tracking. Now if you go to OP is basically order place. So let's say you have created a quote and the customer says, okay, fine, place the order, I'm fine, please start the work. Then you just need to click on order place. It will make this status as order placed. Otherwise, it could be like quote created quote. When you click on this, then it will be order placed. Once the order is placed, then you go to S, site progress, right? Before site progress, there are few things, other thing that needs to be done. Like before that, you basically create a purchase orders because you need to purchase the material for that, right? So what you say, you click on CPO, create purchase orders. Now you need to select the different vendors. You may have a different vendors for different kind of item. Look, let's say for carcass, you may purchase from different people. Hardware, you may purchase from different people. Accessory, you may purchase from different people. And these vendors you can create from this vendor tab. Whatever the vendors that you are having, I'll just show you the first the vendor part. So you can just go here and add any vendor. Let's say I add another Rohit as a vendor, right? The mobile number, I'll just put it 9876987698. Second mobile email ID, you can just put something, right? Whatever the number, GST number of the client, their address. It could be, and now you can select what kind of vendor is it. Is it accessory one, I mean, or the carcass, hardware, shutter, whatever. Let's say I'll put everything here. I mean, it provides me all the things that is required, right? I'll just click on save then. Okay, so this way you can create multiple vendors. You can update them, delete them, all those things you can do. I'll just come back to quotes. So this is the quote that we have created, the first one. I'll just click on create purchase order. Now I'll just select the vendors for it. So right, whatever the, so Rohit is the vendor that we have created. For this we'll just select, let's say, Sandeep. For this we select again the Rohit, and the, so again the, let's say, some other Sandeep. Now you, when you click on save, right, now it will ask, see, it is showing you all the kits that you have created, what are the components that you have created. Everything is done. If you are happy with all these things, the vendor is fine, the cooking kit you want to buy from this vendor, utensil for this vendor, shutter from this vendor, these different kind of shutters and all those things, you can decide. You can go to any granular level at you want, I mean, as you want. Now, once this part is done, right, you don't have any components, so there is no vendor, just click on save. Once you click save, the purchase order will be created. Now, the purchase order that you have created will not be sent directly to the vendors. You need to click come on the purchase order, and here all the purchase orders will be created. You just need to click on mail. Once you click on mail, these purchase orders will be sent to their mail ID or maybe the SMS, whichever way you want, or maybe the WhatsApp in future if you want. All these, it will be automatically sent to their ID and they can just work on that. So this way you can see, like if you see here, you can see any purchase order also. I'll just show you the purchase order. So this is the purchase order that you have created for them. Whatever you want to buy, what is the height, weight, what is the color, quantity, square feet, and all those things. See, it has been done automatically. Everything is done automatically. So this is the way you create purchase order. This format can again be changed, right? Okay, and if you want to delete, you can delete it. So these purchase orders will be created. Now purchase order is created, you have received the material. Now the next thing that is, that comes into picture is the site progress. So you can go here, click on site progress. Now you can decide if the material, first thing that is, material is delivered, if the material has been delivered or not. You click on this. Let's say you have click on material delivered, you click on OK. Once you click on OK, you can see the site progress status will be material delivered, and the client will receive the SMS for the same. So this way, whenever you, whatever is happening on the site, you can just keep doing that, and it will keep showing you all the things, like what is the status of the site exactly happening. Now you click, let's say kitchen is complete, you click on kitchen complete. Okay, you can also send a feedback form to the client at the end so that he can fill in whatever the feedback he may have. So this is all about the things. You can delete it, you can see the details of the quotes from here, and you can search it through any, you can generate the reports from it. So all these things, it is a basically maintaining your modular kitchen business as a whole. Now you can go here and you can put in some company details here. So these are the details that you can update from here. Some company name, company mobile number, certification, SIN number, GST number, your address, and all other things that you want to basically you can create your profile, you can change your password, you can create users. So create user is basically, again, as I told you, like you can create multiple users into it and they can log into the system, right? So this is a simple part. So basically, friends, this is all about the Asan Kitchen module, I mean the software, and for any other details, you can please contact us. Thank you.